This is HOI News Daybreak. Accurate, balanced, to the point.
Good morning, heart of Illinois. You're looking at downtown Peoria from Unity Point Health Methodist. Traffic flowing well on I-74. It is 6 a.m. and 18 degrees. Welcome to HOI News Daybreak. I'm Mark Welp.
And I'm Gretchen Wertz on this Thursday. It is February 2nd, Groundhog Day. We are anxiously awaiting what Gertie has to say. We're going to go out live to Wildlife Prairie Park in just a little bit and check on her. But right before 7, we'll find out. 6 more weeks of winter or early spring? We'll see. Today feels a little colder, though. We've got 29 degrees for a high, but we are expecting some sunshine, so that's good. A little nicer looking out there over the next few days. But yes, you'll need to bundle up a little more. Mark?
Peoria Mayor Jim Artis's annual State of the City address takes on new significance in the wake of Caterpillar announcing it's moving its world headquarters to Chicago. Mayor Artis mentioned Cat, but said it was time to move on. He mostly talked about the strong health care systems in the heart of Illinois, the 11.5% drop in crime, and fighting poverty.
If we work together to address poverty in our community as the root cause of many things that hold us back, we will be much better off. And this is not an endeavor for a few. It requires us all.
The mayor added the city is focusing a lot of energy and resources on the 61605 area code on Peoria's south side. The mayor's reassurance about Caterpillar probably won't resolve everyone's fears about Peoria's future. We spoke to a local financial advisor yesterday about what the move could mean going forward and how you can prepare yourself and your investments.
We have a diverse economy here, and a good part of our 1% here in Central Illinois is not that those 300 that are leaving. We still have a lot of medical professionals, a lot of legal professionals, a lot of small business owners that make up that 1%. So hopefully we're diversified enough that we won't feel this.
Elger added that charitable organizations might end up feeling the Cat departure the most, since the 300 upper management employees involved made up a big chunk of their donation base. A major credit rating agency downgrades Illinois' rating, citing the unprecedented failure to approve a state budget. Fitch Ratings lowered the rating yesterday on nearly $26 billion of general obligation bonds from BBB plus to BBB. That's a few levels above junk status. Illinois already has the worst rating of any state. The lower rating means taxpayers pay more when Illinois borrows money. Lawmakers haven't passed a budget for 2 years, and spending is occurring at levels far in excess of what the state is bringing in. Fitch says even if the Senate is successful in passing a budget deal, the prolonged inaction has fundamentally weakened the state's financial profile. The Trump White House has a brand new Secretary of State. Former ExxonMobil CEO Rex Tillerson was sworn in Wednesday night in the Oval Office.
There are already new challenges for the nation's top diplomat. On top of having to deal with the president's executive order on immigration, the White House is making new headlines on Iran and Australia. ABC's Elizabeth Herr reports.
This morning, top U.S. ally Australia criticized by President Trump on Twitter over a deal to resettle some refugees in the U.S. The president saying in a late-night tweet, "Do you believe it? The Obama administration agreed to take thousands of illegal immigrants from Australia. Why? I will study this dumb deal." But the Australian Prime Minister telling a different story.
"The president assured me that he would continue with honor the agreement."
According to the Washington Post, the president slammed the Australian Prime Minister during a weekend phone call over a deal struck by the Obama administration. The Post also reporting that the president accused Australia of trying to export, quote, the next Boston bombers to the U.S. ABC News has not independently confirmed details of the call. The Australian Prime Minister will only say the call ended courteously, but beyond that, no comment.
It's better that these conversations are conducted candidly, frankly, privately.
This just hours after the White House issued a stern warning to Iran.
"As of today, we are officially putting Iran on notice."
The warning in response to Iran testing another ballistic missile and other recent provocative actions on U.S. warships.
So from Iran to Australia, the travel ban in Mexico, Secretary of State Rex Tillerson, who was just sworn in last night, certainly has his plate full as he reports to work for his first full day on the job today. Elizabeth Herr, ABC News, New York.
A standoff continues at a prison in Smyrna, Delaware, where inmates are reportedly holding two corrections department workers hostage. Two other hostages have been released. Inmates at the James T. Vaughn Correctional Center told a local newspaper that concerns about their treatment and President Donald Trump prompted their actions.
At least six people are injured after demonstrations turned violent overnight at UC Berkeley in California. Students protested a speech yesterday for Milo Yiannopoulos, the senior editor for the conservative website Breitbart. The school blamed the violence on masked agitators who they say were there to disrupt an otherwise peaceful protest. Many students seem supportive of those peaceful protests, while other students express concern about the violence.
Free speech movement was founded here, and tonight someone's free speech got shut down. And I know it might have been hateful speech that he was bringing to this campus, but it's still his right to speak.
The university blamed most of the violence not on students, but a small group of well-known anarchists known as the Black Bloc.
Are you worried about how to pay for your kid's college degree or maybe still dealing with your own student loans? You're not alone. The College Board says that students took on $100 billion in student loan debt in 2016 alone. Many schools are also raising tuition rates and graduate unemployment rates are spiking, which is why a local high school is helping students look for career options that won't break the bank.
Students at PCHS will be college and career ready, and you know, the decision is theirs. We're not going to shut doors to either pathway.
There are valuable benefits and steep costs that come with every college decision. Stay tuned tonight for HOI News at 10 when Mason Dowling breaks down the pros and cons and helps you decide the value of a college degree.
Interesting.
Very interesting. Yeah, I have to tune in for that. All right, and we'll probably see it tomorrow here on our show as well. But right now, let's get a look at our weather as we step out. It's cold. Bundle up out there. Temperatures are starting off here in the teens and only getting up to about 29 degrees today. So a little colder than what we've seen here. February getting a little colder. The good thing is we've got these clear skies, so we'll turn into sunshine. 17 right now in Bloomington Normal. The winds are calming down a little bit. 16 actually in the Twin Cities. 17 in Peoria right now. Let's look around the area. 17 in Galesburg. 20 degrees in Canton. Havana coming in with 21, Princeville at 18 degrees up in La Salle, Peru, a little colder, 16 right now, 19 in Pontiac and in Mount Hope in McLean County, you're looking at 18 degrees. Pretty clear sky, satellite radar showing, pretty nice clear overnight, so it did get a little cold out there, and these clear skies, though, do bring in sunshine, and we got a little glimpse of it yesterday, which was nice, and we'll see more of that here today, tomorrow, and even into the weekend now, so that's good. Clear skies, of course, a little colder, these upper 20s, low 30s is what we're going to be getting used to here these next few days. Starts off this morning in the teens. The winds are still a little strong in places, but calming down by the afternoon. 29 degrees for that high, 15 tonight. Partly cloudy and, yeah, a little bit chilly out there. 30 degrees is how we'll start our weekend tomorrow. Again, should be pretty sunny. And our Saturday now, we talked about some little light snow flurries over the weekend. We're taking that out now. Saturday, 34 degrees with a little sun. Probably more sun on Sunday with 40. Showers on Monday, 43. We're up to 46 Tuesday, which is nice. But at night, it gets cold again. Some light snow comes in, and then it's expected to continue into Wednesday. So today a little cold, but clear skies. So that could mean the groundhog sees a shadow, and that could mean six more weeks of winter. So we'll see.
The pressure.
The pressure of having a nice sunny day today. You got to have more winter.
Well, we'll take you out to Wildlife Prairie Park a little bit later in the show, tell you what's going on. And let's take a look at this morning's riddle of the day.
In Clark County, Nevada, they do not use a groundhog to predict the weather. Since 2000, the Red Rock Canyon National Conservation Area has used Mojave Max to predict the arrival of spring. What is Mojave Max? What is Mojave Max? Think you know? Send your guess right here, Daybreak at HYNews.com. Coming up here in about 45 minutes, we're going to pick one very lucky winner.
And if we pick your name, you can pick up a great gift certificate for a local restaurant. Just get your guesses in with your full name.
All right, we've got more coming up. Keep it right here.
You're watching HOI ABC News Daybreak with Mark Welp and Gretchen Wertz's HOI Storm Team Weather. This is HOI News Daybreak. Accurate, balanced, to the point.
Good morning, heart of Illinois. 29 in Peoria today with some sun, a little cloudy in Chicago, 23. St. Louis just above freezing there with some sunshine today. Mark?
Traveling for work definitely has its perks, but it can wreak havoc on your habits. CNN's Kim Hutcherson has some tips on keeping fit while traveling in today's Health Minute.
If you travel for work, eating healthy and exercising often fall by the wayside. And it doesn't help if meals are on your company's dime. Here are some tips for staying healthy on the road. For starters, don't treat business travel as a vacation. Most people tend to put their workout routines on hold while traveling, and that can set back your fitness goals. Before you hop on a plane or hit the open road, do some research. Get online and find a workout facility or fitness class that you can fit into your schedule. Worst case scenario, there's always the hotel gym. Most are equipped with a few cardio machines and free weights. It's not much, but it gets the job done. And if your hotel has no gym, try packing some workout equipment like a jump rope or suspension bands. They're easy to pack and easy to use. And probably the toughest thing to do while traveling for work is maintaining a healthy diet. Plan to eat small amounts throughout the day to keep from getting hungry. Healthy snacks are great to keep handy, and skip the drive-thru. You'll have better luck finding healthy options at a local grocery store. And don't forget to drink plenty of water. For today's Health Minute, I'm Kim Hutcherson.
But when it's on the bus, it's dying.
Oh, I know. I had a job where I traveled, and having that company credit card.
Mm-hmm. That's a chance to have the good
it's
stuff.
It's intoxicating.
Exactly. All right. Well, let's get a look at our weather on this February 2nd, Groundhog Day. We're looking at some sunshine. We're going to see temperatures a little colder today, 29 for a high. We're starting off in the teens, about 24 this evening on the way home. We got more coming up. Keep it right here. Good morning, Heart of Illinois. 29 degrees today, some sunshine. We'll see the sun for a little bit here. 30 degrees tomorrow. We'll get to the 40s by Sunday. A little chance for some rain on Monday. We now head out live to Wildlife Prairie Park in Hanna City, where Gertie's Groundhog Day event is on. Gertie's going to wake up around 7 this morning to predict either a longer winter or an early spring. Last year, she said it would be an early spring. Gertie gets it right about 75% of the time. Gertie will also predict the Super Bowl winner following the weather forecast. That event, this event out there is free. You can head out to Wildlife Prairie Park right now. They can warm up there by the bonfire. Look at those kids. They're adorable. Don't worry, they'll be in school after this is all over with. And we're going to check back in later. Hi, guys. With Gertie's big announcement a little later on. Mark?
Thank you, Gretchen. Time now for sports. Here's HOI's Lee Hall with more.
Good morning. Two of the hottest teams in the Valley meet at Illinois State, but bad news for the Redbirds before the game even starts. Mekhi'll McIntosh has surgery on his right knee to repair a torn meniscus. He's out indefinitely for right now. Going for 18 straight at home without McIntosh. Tough break for the junior big man. Slow start for both teams. Keshawn Evans drives the lane, gives to Phil Fane. Hey, that rhymes. And they score. One of ISU's Player of the Year candidates, Deontay Hawkins, off the bounce for three. The Redbirds go on a 12-0 run against the Panthers, led by Paris Lee, the senior guard from suburban Chicago, with the three. Then Lee, the steal and the drive. He had 18 points, 5 assists, 3 steals. Northern Iowa would rally, and it's Evans knocking down a huge three in the final minute. Redbirds hold on 57-51. They've won 12 in a row, 18 in a row at home. They are 11-0 in the conference on top in the Valley. Bradley goes to the Dogs, trying to snap a 5-game skid as they visit Southern Illinois. Braves fall behind 17-2. They slowly climb back into it. JoJo McGlaster from the corner for three. He had 14. Later, it's freshman Darryl Brown Jr. for three. He had 14 as well to tie for team high honors. BU still on that comeback trail in the first half. Up top to Dante Thomas. Braves within 6 at the half, but a slow start to the second half would doom the Braves. Brown in the lane. SIU wins at 85-65. Bradley's 6th loss in a row by double digits. They'll host Drake Saturday at 1. Our grand finale. We go to the NBA. Check out Sacramento's Anthony Tolliver at the free throw line. Loses his mouth guard. Makes the free throw. Incredible concentration. Picks it up and puts it right back in. 10-second rule, right, Anthony? Good thing he doesn't wear dentures. It was Illinois Wesleyan, a winner on the road at Millikan, 65-53. We will see you back here tonight. Our friend Mike Plunkett, what an amazing comeback story for him, assistant coach for the Notre Dame basketball girls team. We will have his story coming up on HOI News at 5:30. See you then.
And in NBA action, the Bulls, they beat the Thunder 128-100. Very nice.
There you go.
Big Super Bowl. Do you have a prediction for this week, Ken?
I'm going to go with the Patriots.
Going to go with the Patriots?
Yeah.
By a lot, or you think it'll be a close game?
No, I think it'll be a close game.
Close game, all
right. By touchdown. What about you?
I'm going to go with the Falcons. I think they're going to do it.
Okay.
I think they're going to do it. I want them to do it. All right, let's get a look at the weather. Temperatures a little chilly here this morning. We're starting off at about 17 in Peoria, the Twin Cities right now. Clear skies there. 16, some clear skies sticking around here for the next couple of days, actually. We've got 13 in Rochelle now, a little colder there. 20 in Macomb, 17 degrees in Peoria, 21 in Lincoln, Chicago at 14 right now. And we go to Chillicothe. They're looking at 16 degrees. Clear skies, though. Satellite radar has a pretty nice start here to the day without the blanket of clouds overnight. Got the things a little cold, but it's going to turn into sunshine here a little bit after 7. And looking at future casts, not much changing here over the next 24, 48 hours. We're going to keep the clear skies going, so another cold night, but sunshine back again tomorrow with temps in the low 30s. And we'll keep it going, I think, into Saturday now, too. We thought about maybe some flurries Saturday night. We're taking that out, and it looks like it'll be pretty good here through the weekend. So 29 degrees today. After a chilly start here, we're only going to get up to about 29, so pretty chilly all day. 15 degrees tonight. Again, a few little clouds expected. Winds about 5 to 10 miles an hour. 30 degrees for tomorrow. So temperatures staying below normal. We should see a good deal of sunshine again. Saturday, 34 degrees, just a little bit above freezing. Some sun in there. 40 on Sunday, a little better. We'll have again some sunshine. Then Monday, a little rain with 43. Tuesday, we're up to 46, partly sunny during the day. But at night, it gets a little cold. Some snow comes back in. We'll be looking for that there on Wednesday. You're watching Daybreak. Keep it right here. Good morning, heart of Illinois. We've got temperatures starting off here in the teens. We'll get to 29 for a high today. Cold again tomorrow, but we've got that sunshine in. And then a few clouds come in with some showers and even snow for next week. Mark?
The new president gets a red flag for his red ties from some in the fashion industry. Jeannie Most reports on presidential neckwear.
When Jon Stewart came out flinging his endless red tie, you didn't have to be a fashionista to know who he was mocking.
Super long tie, dead animal on head, boom.
Even on Dress Your Best inaugural day, there was no tie when it came to whose tie was longer. And when the wind blew, there it was, tape. The second time Donald Trump had been caught with his tape showing, inspiring tweets like, ran over to Macy's to pick up a Trump brand tie clip, and this Scotch tape is great again hat to go with his tie. The fashion police want the president to say so long to ties that are so long. Business Insider called the length sad. Crimes against cravats screamed a headline. The CVS receipt of ties compared his neckwear to the notoriously long drugstore receipts. If Trump's tie were any lower, it would be his approval rating, tweeted Seth Meyers' show. But why, oh why, does a man with his own line of ties wear them so long? Celebrity stylist Philip Block has a theory.
I believe he is thinking he is hiding his gut. I think he thinks it's creating an elongating sensation, which it sort of does because your eye goes to the long red line that again is pointing down where we don't want to go.
The rule is that the end of your tie is supposed to hit right at the middle of your belt. Your tie should not touch the chair when you sit. GQ suggested the president swap this monstrosity for a skinnier tie. I dressed myself greatly, reads this New Yorker cartoon. But maybe regular guys like that this president's no fashion plate. He's a plate held together with Scotch tape.
But we actually have things called tie clips for that. And they actually have them at the White House. They sell them.
But no point in hitting below the belt like the president's ties do. Jeannie Most, CNN. New York.
Still better than being too short, I would say.
Yes, definitely. Yeah. And I don't see him changing that. He's not going to. Where's your tie hit?
I try and get it to hit the belt.
The belt?
Yeah.
To the middle? What did they say? The middle of
you
the
know,
belt?
Usually it goes down and then it goes out. And then eventually it hits
comes
the belt.
Comes back in. Yeah. Okay. All right. Let's get a look at our weather. A little cold out there. Temperature starting off in the teens. 29 for that high. We'll be right back.
This is HOI News Daybreak. Accurate, balanced, to the point.
Good morning, heart of Illinois. Downtown Peoria, starting to get a little sunlight out there. The sunrise officially happened a little after 7, and we will see some sun again today. That will be nice. Thanks for watching us on Daybreak. Good morning, I'm Gretchen Wertz.
And I'm Mark Welt. Thanks for joining us. We'll see some sun, but will Gertie see her shadow? We'll find out in about a half an hour here. We'll take you out live to Wildlife Prairie Park in just a few minutes.
But right now, let's talk about the weather here, and it is a lot colder. You'll notice that here this morning. Temps in the teens. We are expecting sunshine, a high of just 29 degrees today. More on all this in just a bit. Mark.
Hundreds of people in the heart of Illinois attend a solidarity rally in the wake of President Trump's immigration order.
HOI's Trish Christakis reports from Bloomington.
The auditorium was filled as hundreds piled in with signs to support the community and their neighbors. Mike Matika, a Not in Our Town member, says their goal is to make sure that no one feels targeted or that they're somehow less of a citizen because of what's going on in Washington, D.C.
So we wanted to come together in our diversity of various people in McLean County and reiterate that we're all part of one community, we're all here together, and we support each other.
And they weren't alone.
Bloomington Normal is a welcoming community. We welcome diversity in our community, and we welcome people who want to be in our community to have a better life.
Now, members in the audience are encouraged to fill out one of these note cards and put down any questions or concerns they may have to send to their state legislators. Now, one woman told me there's something very important she'd like to add to hers.
And speak truth to power and make sure that they are making decisions that protect the country and protect people's rights from being eroded and not just merely to become elected.
That was Trish Christakis reporting. President Trump honors the Heart of Illinois Navy SEAL killed over the weekend with a surprise trip to Delaware's Dover Air Base. The president met with the family of William Ryan Owens yesterday. Owens died during a raid on an Al-Qaeda base in Yemen. The Navy SEAL Chief Special Warfare Operator was from Peoria. He graduated from Illinois Valley Central High School in Chillicothe in 1998. Three other Americans were wounded in the operation, which was planned by former President Barack Obama's administration, but approved by President Trump.
The Chicago Police Department releases its crime numbers for January. The city had 51 murders last month compared to 50 in January of 2016. The department unveiled a new web-based system that analyzes information such as arrests and gang activity. The data is gathered from gunshot detection technology to help the department predict where violent crime might occur.
Throughout 2017, CPD will focus on initiatives that aim to reduce violence, increase the capability of our police officers, and rebuild public trust. Through these investments, we will make this a safer year for the city of Chicago. I promise you.
Johnson says the number of shootings in Chicago dropped, but the number of shooting victims went up to 299 people. Gun recoveries are up more than 60%, and gun arrests have more than doubled. Peoria Crime Stoppers increases its reward to $5,000. Law enforcement officials announced yesterday that Crime Stoppers will pay the cash award for information that leads to a homicide suspect's arrest. The previous award was $1,000. Law enforcement sees this as a big boost.
It's just a huge opportunity by raising this amount of money to allow us to do our job. And I think this is just going to be a tremendous asset.
We do need that help in getting some of these cases solved. We have a large number of cases, that violent cases, that need some assistance. And we're hopeful that these things today, these new measures, will increase that participation.
Crime Stoppers scrubs and deletes all emails, phone calls, and texts once a tip proves successful. The number to call if you have a tip is 673-9000.
Some people in Peoria graduate from a new program that helps the city's minority community members. Montique Allen is one of seven students who graduated yesterday from the New Millennium Institute's 2.5-week job readiness boot camp. The intensive program was created to break the cycle of poverty and crime in Peoria. Allen and another student say the program provided them with the tools to create a better future for themselves.
This program gave me an outlook on life where I made a 5-year plan and I could visualize that plan and move forward and be successful in life.
It basically starts with my mindset. It helps me change the way I think, the way I plan, and the way I organize myself.
Allen says he's more confident in himself than before he enrolled in the program.
636, Illinois gets a big reimbursement from the federal government because of a Legionnaire's disease outbreak at a Quincy Veterans Home. The Department of Veterans Affairs is giving the state $4 million for a new water treatment facility. The Legionnaire's outbreak killed 12 people and made at least 54 people sick in 2015. A federal report found the bacteria was likely spread by an aging water system. The new water treatment facility should be done this month.
Some Richwoods High School students embrace Muslim culture. Richwoods High School's Muslim Student Association invited female classmates to join them in wearing hijabs on their heads yesterday as part of World Hijab Day. Organizers say it's important to raise awareness about the Muslim faith and culture.
We as Muslims have been targeted as a religion that's violent and that promotes violent acts. With everything that's going on around the world, people are just getting the wrong message.
It's very important just letting everybody know that they're welcomed and that everybody's different, but we all have the same blood, that we're all together.
This is the second year Richwood students have celebrated World Hijab Day. The Caterpillar Visitor Center opens a new exhibit honoring Black History Month. The exhibit opened yesterday. It features stories told through film, photographs, and artifacts. Many of those were provided by the Smithsonian National Museum of African American History and Culture.
It's the American story told through the African American lens, but that lens looked out onto an interracial world. So no matter who you are, you'll see yourself in this museum.
Caterpillar was instrumental in bringing the exhibit here and helping fund the African American Museum in Washington. CAT officials say the visitor center will stay in Peoria despite the world headquarters moving to Chicago.
Gertie the Groundhog will wake up bright and early this morning to give her official forecast. Last year she said it would be an early spring. Gertie gets it right about 75% of the time. All the festivities begin at 6 at Wildlife Prairie Park with the official forecast coming around 7. Gertie will also make her annual Super Bowl prediction. The event is free until 9 a.m. We're going to head out there live in just a little bit to see what's going on. And, with sunshine out there, a good chance she will see her shadow, which means 6 more weeks of winter.
Mild winter?
Well, that's the way it's going. Yeah, that could be. But technically, there are 6 more weeks of winter, so we can't really escape that. Let's get a look now at our weather temperatures. Colder. We've started off in the teens. We're going to hit 29 degrees today, below normal. Most of January was above normal. We're getting a little colder here. 17 in Peoria right now. The wind's calming down a bit. 16 in Bloomington normal. The wind's picking up there a little bit. 15 mile an hour wind gusts, so it makes the wind chill feel a little colder. 16 in Galesburg, 20 in Canton right now, 21 in Havana. We've got 21 in Lincoln, Mossville at 18 degrees, 15 in LaSalle, Purdue, and 16 in Germantown Hills. Clear skies looking pretty good out there. You're going to get some sunshine going first thing here this morning, which is good. Maybe not good for Gertie. Could mean more longer winter. But we're going to keep things pretty nice here over the next couple of days. Of course, cold without the clouds tonight. Temps will dip into the teens again. We'll see temps tomorrow hit 30 degrees and a little bit just above freezing by Saturday. And Sunday, actually get back into the 40s. But today we're looking at teens to start off with. So you got to bundle up. Hats, gloves needed today. As we head into the afternoon, temperatures only up to about 29. So a little colder than yesterday. 15 tonight. We see the clear skies for the most part. And then 30 degrees for tomorrow. Kicking off our weekend with another cold one. Saturday, I think we'll keep some sunshine in there. 34 degrees for a high. Sunday, we get up to 40, which is good. And I think we'll get some sunshine in there. Monday and Tuesday, 40s. A little bit better there. Some showers Monday, Tuesday, partly sunny during the day, maybe a little flurry at night. Turns into a little more snow by Wednesday. And look at those temps dropping Wednesday back down to 28 degrees. So we get a little warm up here in the middle of the forecast, but cold today and cold again by next Wednesday.
Let's take one last look at this morning's riddle of the day. In Clark County, Nevada, they do not use a groundhog to predict the weather. Since 2000, the Red Rock Canyon National Conservation Area has used Mojave Max to predict the arrival of spring. What is Mojave Max? Send your answers here and only here, please, to daybreak@hoinews.com. And coming up in 20 minutes, we'll pick another winner.
That's right. We got a great prize for you. So you still got some time left to get in on this one. And we'll have the answer coming up in just a little bit.
Consumer and entertainment news is on the way.
Good morning, Heart of Illinois. We're starting off in the teens this morning. A little chilly, bundle up, but look for those clear skies. You'll need the shades as well. Temperatures only getting up to about 29 degrees this afternoon, so don't let the sun fool you. It'll be a little cold out there. Mark?
After 13 years, Tesla Motors Incorporated is shortening its name to Tesla. The move comes as the company diversifies its business beyond just selling electric cars. Tesla has built a massive gigafactory in Nevada to produce lithium-ion batteries, and it sells a battery system that can power an entire home. CEO Elon Musk has also talked about plans to build heavy-duty trucks and high-passenger density urban transport. In a blog post last year, Musk said that Tesla's mission isn't just to build cars. Facebook is closing in on the 2 billion user mark. The social network's fourth quarter earnings report on Wednesday shows it had 1.86 billion monthly active users as of the end of 2016. Facebook has 1.23 billion users who use it every single day. Facebook sales for the December quarter totaled $8.8 billion. The company's stock rose by nearly 3% in after-hours trading Wednesday following the earnings release. And Groundhog Day is today, and some people are willing to shell out big bucks for a glimpse at Punxsutawney Phil. Hotel website Trivago recently looked at average hotel rates in Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania, where Phil appears every Groundhog Day. It turns out the average price for a one-night hotel stay in Punxsutawney around Groundhog Day stands at $450 a night. By comparison, a hotel room in Houston, where Super Bowl 51 happens this Sunday, is $340.
Wow. Casting news, including a Hacksaw Ridge reunion and the next celeb to get a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. More on these stories in our Hollywood Minute.
You have no idea what's coming.
Actually, we do. After Keanu Reeves hits theaters this month in John Wick Chapter 2, he's headed for Siberia. That's the title of the romantic thriller set to star Reeves as a diamond trader who heads to Russia, where he searches for missing jewels and has a steamy affair with a cafe owner.
You're like gum on a shoe, ain't you?
Give me this.
It's a bit late for target practice now, don't you think?
Hacksaw Ridge, directed by Mel Gibson and co-starring Vince Vaughn, received a half dozen Oscar nominations. Now they're set to re-team as co-stars in the crime thriller Dragged Across Concrete. Gibson and Vaughn will play cops who are suspended for police brutality after a video of their tactics goes viral.
I'm not saying that to be, you know, humble. I'm saying it because it's true.
The next time Adam Levine hits the red carpet, he'll be the honoree. The singer, musician, and occasional actor is set to be honored February 10th with a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Appropriately for a coach on TV's The Voice, the star will be in front of a music school. In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
Kanye and Kim Kardashian West are launching a children's fashion line. Kardashian West announced it on the news on Snapchat, featuring their little three-year-old daughter, North. The reality star said the top picked out some of the colors on some of the designs, including a bright yellow sequin dress and matching shearling jacket. This isn't the first fashion foray for the power couple. Kanye has his famously popular Yeezy fashion line, and his wife launched a Kardashian Kids line with their sisters already in 2014. That was upholstery right there, though. Beyonce and her husband Jay-Z are having twins. The singer posted a pregnancy announcement yesterday on Instagram, along with a flower-filled photo of her baby bump. She said, "We have been blessed two times over. We're incredibly grateful that our family will be growing by two, and we thank you for your well wishes." The babies will join the superstar power couple's five-year-old daughter, Blue Ivy. Did you see the pregnancy announcement? It was kind of weird.
She had
a veil over her head and her belly hanging out, you know, which is cute, but there was, weird flowers and a green veil over her head. It was kind of weird.
No, that's interesting. Mm-hmm. Well, just some advice to them on raising twins. It's going to be real difficult. You're going to have to hire two people to raise your kids for you.
Oh, well, and that's addition to the other nanny, so.
Right.
Three whole nannies.
Might have to start Ubering on the weekends.
Let's get a look at the weather. Temperature starting off here in the teens. We're looking for an early spring, hopefully, from Gertie. Sunny skies and definitely some colder temps the next few days. We'll be right back. Good morning, heart of Illinois. We start off here with temps in the teens. We're going to get up to about 29 degrees today for that high. We are expecting sunny skies, though. It's looking pretty good out there.
And we head out live to Wildlife Prairie Park in Hanna City, where Gertie's Groundhog Day outing is taking place.
Ooh, still in the chalet there.
Yeah. To play. She's just listening to the music.
We're getting ready serenaded. To wake her up. That's right. She'll be getting up here any minute to see whether there's going to be an early spring. And with the sunshine you see out there, I'm guessing she's going to see her shadow. We'll see. She gets it right about 75% of the time.
Seeing everybody else's shadow.
So in that case, yes, I think we will see Gertie's shadow, and that's going to mean six more weeks of winter. She's also going to predict the Super Bowl winner, so we'll see about that. Lots of people out there enjoying all the festivities. It's cold out there. We saw bonfires out there earlier trying to keep warm. So we'll check back in a little bit, see what Gertie has to say here very soon. Peoria Mayor Jim Ardis' annual State of the City address takes on new significance in the wake of Caterpillar announcing that its world headquarters is moving to Chicago. He also talked crime, infrastructure, and a push to bring 1,000 jobs to the city.
The mayor says the State of the City address was not one that he had planned to give before the big announcement. HOI's Jessica Cook reports.
It didn't take long for Peoria Mayor Jim Artis to discuss what many anticipated would be first on his agenda, starting off by saying what would have been his opening comments.
I thanked Caterpillar for continuing to have confidence in their investments here, and I said I was glad that their world headquarters was here.
Tuesday's announcement shocked city officials, but Artis added there's a renewed energy moving forward. He didn't stay on the topic of Caterpillar long, talking about the growing stability of healthcare.
This diversification of our economy over the last nearly 50 years has paid off and helped us keep our heads above water during some very difficult economic times. We truly aren't just a one-horse town.
Poverty was also heavily addressed, as Artis called it the most important topic in our community right now.
There's not enough money for us or anybody else to contribute to a pot to say this is going to take care of poverty. And throwing money at it isn't the answer. I mean, it's a lot of the things we talked about, starting with education.
It's a direct tie to what we've been doing with the community conversations on racial equity and economic opportunity. So it just builds off of that.
A major credit rating agency downgrades Illinois' rating, citing the unprecedented failure to approve a state budget. Fitch Ratings lowered the rating yesterday on nearly $26 billion of general obligation bonds from BBB+ to BBB. That's a few levels above junk status. Illinois already has the worst rating of any state. The lower rating means taxpayers pay more when Illinois borrows money. Lawmakers haven't passed a budget for 2 years, and spending is occurring at levels far in excess of what the state brings in. Fitch says even if the Senate is successful in passing a budget deal, the prolonged inaction has fundamentally weakened the state's financial profile.
All right, well, we're going to get a look at our weather here. We're listening in for Gertie. We're going to let you know as soon as we hear what she has to say. But starting off this morning, a little cold. Cold temperatures. We're in the teens right now here in Peoria. The wind's not too bad. They've picked up a little bit more in the Twin Cities, 16 degrees there. The wind chill feels like 2 degrees, so a little bit breezy over there. 13 in Rochelle, 15 in Savannah, 17 in Moline right now. We've got 21 degrees in Lincoln. Chicago coming in with 14, Champaign at 19, Elmwood at 18 degrees this morning. So clear skies. Doesn't look like there's much cloud cover out there in Hanna City there by Wildlife Prairies, so we're expecting probably for Gertie to see the shadow. We've got clear skies coming at you today and actually the next couple of days. Futurecast's keeping things pretty clear. That means a little colder weather during the day, and especially at night. We'll drop back into the teens tonight. Tomorrow we're looking at about 30 degrees for our start of our weekend here. Again, pretty sunny. We'll get above freezing by Saturday and back into the 40s by Sunday. So today, this afternoon, we'll hit 29 degrees, a little colder than yesterday for sure. Winds 5 to 15 miles an hour, so not too bad. 15 overnight, another chilly night as we see just a little bit of cloud cover. And then 30 degrees tomorrow as we head into the weekend. Mostly sunny skies and temperatures, yes, dropping below normal here. 34 on Saturday, a little bit above freezing, and we'll have some sun in there. Sunday, look for the temps to go up a little more, 40 degrees for that high with some sun. Monday, there's a chance for some showers. Monday, 43. Tuesday, we're actually up to 46, and there may be some snow at night. That will come in later at night and into Wednesday, a little colder. Some light snow expected there for the middle of the week, a high of 28. Kids Count weather picture winner today. This one's from London Marie, 2 years old from Mattoon, with a little leftover Christmas tree here. So thank you very much, London. Great picture. We got a great prize for you. And coming up here, we're going to see what Gertie has to say, give you the answer to the riddle in just a bit.
Good morning. Coming up on GMA, there's violent protests breaking out overnight at UC Berkeley. You see it right there. The speech of a right-wing writer, Miley Yiannopoulos, you see him right there from Breitbart, had to be canceled after the protests. Donald Trump weighing in this morning saying he might cut federal funds to Berkeley. We're going to get into all the controversy this morning on GMA.
This is HOI News Daybreak. Accurate, balanced, to the point.
Good morning, heart of Illinois. 19 degrees to start with. A little cold, sunny skies. 29 for that high today. Still waiting on Gertie. We'll let you know, Mark.
Time now for our Daybreak headlines, a look at some of the local stories topping our news this morning. Peoria Mayor Jim Artis' annual State of the City addressed Caterpillar moving its world headquarters to Chicago, but the mayor says it's time to move on. He talked about the strong health care systems in the heart of Illinois, the 11.5% dropping the crime rate, and fighting poverty. The mayor added the city is focusing a lot of resources on Peoria's south side. Many people are wondering about Peoria's future after the CAT announcement. A local financial advisor says we have a diverse economy and a good part of our top earners are not the 300 upper management employees that are leaving. He says charitable organizations might end up feeling the CAT departure the most. And hundreds of people in the heart of Illinois attend a solidarity rally in the wake of President Trump's immigration order. A Not In Our Town member says their goal is to make sure no one feels targeted because of what's going on in Washington, D.C. Normal Mayor Chris Coos says Bloomington Normal welcomes people who want to be in our community to have a better life.
All right, let's get a look at the riddle here, see if you got the answer to this one today, our groundhog trivia. Clark County, Nevada, they don't use the groundhog. They use Mojave Max. You know what Mojave Max is, Mark?
I'm going to guess it's a snake or something gross.
Close. It is a desert tortoise.
Close enough.
Tortoise, yes.
Those are gross. By the way, Punxsutawney Phil saw his shadow.
Saw his shadow, okay.
Yeah, not that we care the way he thinks.
But we're going to go with what we want to hear.
But Gertie's taking her time.
Gertie's taking her time, I guess. All right.
Our winner is Lori Utter.
Uher.
That's an H. Chillicothe, congratulations.
All right. Remember 6 years ago this date? We were snowed in at the Morton Holiday Inn?
Yes, I do.
The big blizzard, 15, 19 inches of snow out there. Yikes.
Goodbye, Ruby Tuesday.
Let's get a look at the weather. We've got 29 today, some sunshine, 30 tomorrow. Saturday, 34. Any news yet from Gertie? 40 on Sunday? Nothing?
Now, tune in to Good Company tonight at 5 p.m. We will have a...
I'm saying shadow.
You think so?
Yeah, 6
we'll let you know what happened. We'll have team coverage. Have a good night.